Hello there, Jeff Carter here, and today I'm going to make you one of my wonderful little water features. You can have it on your patio, even a small garden, or like this one's going to be for me, it's going to be an indoor water feature. There's nothing better than the sound of running water. So come on, let's get started. The first thing you need is something to hold the water in. And this is a nice bowl, but I don't know whether you can see, it's got an hole in it. So the first thing we've got to do is seal this hole. So that's the first job. Okay then, the first thing we've got to do is seal this hole up. So some hot glue around there like that, and I've got a piece of old pond liner, and just press that down nice and firm. Okay, and same on the other side. We'll put it there like that. Nice blob of glue all the way around, some in the hole. Yeah, get that round there like that. Press the liner down and leave that now for 5 minutes to dry, and then we'll move on to the next bit. Now we need some type of grid to hold the surface stuff on. So here, as you can see, we've got something off my old barbecue. So we need to mark this up now and cut it to shape. Just like that. Put it on there. Quite central there now. And mark it off. Possibly about a centimetre less than the circle. So it'll sit lower down in the pot. Now we're going to whiz it. Okay, let's offer it up and see if it fits. Yeah. That'll fit nicely when you press it down now. There you go, see? Nice. Okay, the next thing we've got to think about is the pump. So we've got a little pump here. It's only 950 litres per hour. So it's not that strong. It'll just give a nice little flow to it. We've got to add a piece of pipe yet. So we'll add this to the feature now and then join some pipe to the correct height. So let's remove that for a moment and get the pump. And put it roughly in the middle if you wanted, but this one I'm going to have things around the back, so I'm going to put it slightly forward on this, press it down, then get the wire out the back there, and just, in fact we'll go like that so the wire can go through one of them, and we just press it down again. Now that's not high enough now, so we add a piece of pipe which we'll glue in a minute, just to get the right height and mark it off. So let's just mark it about 1.5 centimetres, 15 mil above. I'll show you why in a minute. Time for the glue gun again. Just put some glue around the end here, like that, and then simply slide on the pipe like that and just put it into place. Now we slide the grate on, just push that through the thing there like that, and put the wire through the back and push it down and position this where you want it, and I think just about there will be fine. Yep, and that's ready for the next step now. Okay, let's put some water in so we can test the pump, and you want to fill this up about 3/4. Okay, now the vessel is full, 3/4 of the way, covers the pump. It's time now just to test the pump before we start dressing. So 1, 2, 3, hey presto, fantastic, that's looking great, just what we want. Okay, the next step. Now we add some small plastic strips and just place them round, just to stop stuff from falling through, just like that, and cover it all nicely. There you go. Now it's time to dress the feature, and one of my favourite little pieces, what's going to go on here today, is a nice piece of rock, just to give it some background. And then I've got lots of pieces of slate, what I'm going to put round now. So we could just put it either side of the fountain there, and just take your time building up the feature. Just add in little bits as you go along. You know, take your time with it. Like that. And we're going to cover the full area now with slate. Just like that. And now, because I want a Japanese feel to this water feature, I'm going to get some bamboo from my garden. Why not? It's free. So just get some pieces like that, different lengths, get another one from the side, just like that, and there we have it, bamboo. Now we can just put the bamboo through the tiny slots, just press them in like that. These will last a few weeks, but look at the difference it makes. One there at the back. Nope, put it at the side here then. Yeah. And we'll just put a stone there just to keep it up. That's it. So now we just carry on with our slate and build it up slowly but surely. Just like that. Until it's completely covered. Okay, let's go into my art studio for the stars of the show. Come on, let me show you what I've been painting. Three little monk boys, and I've painted them in acrylic paint. So we need to just seal them now with an acrylic lacquer. Okay? Just like this. Give them a nice coat and make them waterproof. Okay, let's add a couple of more features. Bring in a couple of the old bonsai trees there in the background. Like that. A bit of depth. Beautiful. And I've just got some moss now out the garden. Put some moss round to make it more natural. And that'll stay damp because of the fountain. That. And finally add the little monk boys and put one there. Nice. One in the middle. And there. Yep. And finally there. So there we have it, my wonderful little Japanese water feature. Absolutely beautiful. So there we have it, folks, my wonderful little Japanese water feature. I hope you all enjoyed that. If you did, give us a thumbs up, leave some comments below, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the little bell. We love it when you do that. It's perfect for a small garden, a little patio, or even in your dining room, conservatory, or even in your front room. There's nothing better than running water. Absolutely fantastic. And that's it from me. And I've only got one more thing to say. And the main thing is, keep smiling.